Sex determination has two aspects. The first is a network of genes that are essential for the development of female and male sex organs. Most of these genes can be found in both male and female genomes, but their expression differs between the sexes. These genes are highly conserved in evolution. The second aspect is the lottery mechanism that decides which sexual organs will develop in an individual. These lottery mechanisms are highly diverse and flexible in evolution. In many animals, sex is determined genetically by sex chromosomes. These chromosomes and their role in sex determination were discovered by Nettie Stevens. In mammals and many other groups, sex chromosomes are called X and Y, and other chromosomes are called autosomes. In humans, for example, the female has, in addition to the two sets of 22 autosomes, two X chromosomes. Males, in contrast, have, in addition to the autosomes, one X and one Y chromosome. You will recall that when sperm cells are formed, each of the four products of meiosis gets one set of autosomes. In addition, it gets an X or a Y chromosome. Half of the sperm will thus contain an X and half a Y. Females, in contrast, have only X chromosomes, and therefore all eggs will have an X chromosome. As you see in this table, the probability for the birth of a male or a female is always 50%. Hence, the ratio of females to males in the population is roughly 1 to 1. It is further easy to see that the male determines the sex of the offspring. Whether the reproductive system develops in the embryo into a male or a female depends on the presence or absence of a Y chromosome. In the absence of a Y, a female system develops by default. The SRY gene, encoded on chromosome Y, leads to the development of a male system. The protein encoded by SRY leads to the expression of several autosome-encoded proteins that control the development of the male system. In humans, a single Y is sufficient, even if due to chromosomal abnormalities, there is more than one X chromosome. This XXXY system determines the sex of mammals, some other vertebrates, and some insects. In most beetles and flies, the sex determination mechanism is called XXX0. In this mechanism, the sex is determined by the number of X chromosomes. An individual with one X chromosome is a male, and an individual with two is a female. This mechanism is widespread also in spiders, grasshoppers, cockroaches, dragonflies, and many other insects. In birds, as well as in some reptiles and amphibians, there is an opposite system called ZZZW. Here, the female has two different sex chromosomes called Z and W. Males, in contrast, have only Z chromosomes. In this mechanism, eggs can either have a Z or a W chromosome, while all sperm have a Z chromosome. It is easy to understand that therefore in birds the sex is determined by the mother. This mechanism can also be found in butterflies. A further mechanism of chromosome-based sex determination is found in ants, bees, and wasps. In these insects, haploid individuals that hatch from unfertilized eggs will be males, while diploid individuals that hatch from fertilized eggs will be females. Whether these females will be queens and fertile, or infertile laborers or soldiers, is determined by environmental rather than genetic cues. Sex determination by chromosomes is widespread, but it is not the only existing mechanism. In many animals, in particular in reptiles, sex is determined by environmental factors, usually by temperature. Males hatch from turtle eggs incubated at low temperature, while females hatch from eggs incubated at higher temperature. In crocodiles, females hatch from eggs incubated at high and low temperatures, while males hatch from eggs incubated at intermediate ones. We have no idea how sex determination worked in dinosaurs. However, as they were reptiles, it is possible that they too used a temperature-dependent mechanism. Dinosaur extinction coincided and was possibly caused by an abrupt climatic change triggered by the impact of a huge meteorite. Temperature-dependent sex determination depends on subtle differences in incubation temperature of 1 or 2 centigrades. The climatic change triggered by the meteorite could have thus caused a significant change in the males to females ratio, a change that could have led to dinosaur extinction. In recent years, our climate is getting warmer due to human activity. Among many ill effects of global warming, it can thus also affect the sex ratio of many species. This figure, that summarizes a comprehensive review on sex determination, enables you, without getting into details, to get an impression of the abundance of such mechanisms in their distribution among different animal groups. This variability is rather surprising in view of the high evolutionary conservation of most other aspects of sex. One reason for this variability might be that Y and W chromosomes lack homologs and cannot undergo meiotic recombination. It is paradoxical that the chromosomes that enable sexual reproduction are not reaping its benefits, meiotic recombination that is essential for repairing and maintaining chromosomes. Sex chromosomes are therefore not stable, and the evolutionary process must keep inventing new sex chromosomes or other mechanisms of sex determination.